okay, in the interest of trying to make this class more fun, I am going to pass the pen to Edmund. He is the hand. You are the brain. Let's work on this problem together. What is the interval in which G is decreasing? Edmund does not have to think. All he has to do is write.
Well, the derivative of G. Start with the derivative.
Derivative of G, do you agree, Jordan?
Well, I was going to say, it says you can use your graphing calculator. Yes. So.
You know what? Yes, you can use your graphing calculator, but I'd like to turn to this using analytical methods. Since we have the ability to talk about it, let's see what we can do. All
right.
Okay, so find the derivative. Help out Edmund, please.
It's 3x squared minus 12x. Times b to the x cubed minus 6x squared plus 1. And then we set that equal to 0.
Subtract.
Edmund, divide both sides. You can't subtract.
Okay. Anthony wants to divide both sides by a value. My only worry is, could you end up doing an illegal divide by zero? You could, but I think Anthony would argue in this case, can e to any power ever be negative?
No,
and it can't be zero either. The expression e to whatever, as long as the whatever is real,
it's going to be 1 or 0.
Yeah.
No, it's going to be 0. It's going to be higher than 0. It's always positive.
Very close.
So if Anthony wants to get rid of the e to the he can do that, and he will not have broken any algebraic laws because that thing could never be 0.
Right.
I respect that.
You're right. And now you're going to have a critical point at 0, so I would put like a line there.
there's already a line there, and another line at 4. And then, it does not exist before 0, so you can just erase all that.
Wait. No, that's not the derivative.
Oh, the derivative, never mind.
Yeah.
Well, no.
I'll say that one more time.
No, that's still right because of the.
Look, if you look at the 3x,
all of that, you're multiplying by a very small number, it's close to 0. You're still going to get a.
Can you take e to a negative power?
Yeah.
Yes.
Can you take e to a positive power?
Yes.
Can you take e to 0?
Yes.
So are there any values that keep you? Are there any values that keep you from putting some value in that polynomial expression, which is the exponent on e? I don't see any restrictions on the domain here.
I was thinking.
It's all good.
Oh well.
Okay.
So if you put in a negative number. If you put in a number between 0 and 4, you're going to get each positive.
But the first part would be negative,
so you're going to get negative.
It'll be negative.
Negative.
Yeah. 0 and 4 will be negative.
And then higher than 4, it would be positive.
Yeah,
because of first.
Yeah.
So what's the question?
What is it?
It's like
between 0 and 4.
It's
B.
That's decreasing.
So the answer is decreasing.
Odd interval.
You put the closed interval.
It's decreasing the closed interval from 0 to 4.
So it's letter B.
Do they also include the open interval from 0 to 4 as an answer?
Yeah,
no.
No,
just kidding.
That'd be tricky.
That's the only.
That's my word.
If they did do that, wouldn't that be like.
And again, you know.
Yeah,
that'd be. Well, there's a lot of these little gotchas in mathematics, right? What is the definition of an isosceles triangle?
Two
sides are
equal.
You agree? Yeah. A triangle that has two equal sides.
At
least.
Yeah.
At least. You mean or is it a triangle with at least two equal sides?
Or that side has exactly two equal sides.
Exactly. Would you believe that in geometry books there's a debate? Mm-hmm. I land in the camp that you want to use at least. Because that means that every single equilateral triangle also has all the properties of a isosceles triangle, which is absolutely true. But there are some textbooks that describe an isosceles triangle as having exactly two equal sides. I don't see any advantage in that. Okay? So there may be internal debates, again, based on definitions. All right. So I think that was well done. I only have one small itsy-bitsy criticism. I'm going to do it in blue. And that is this. This number line, what does it represent? Is it G or is it G prime?
G prime.
Okay, when we do this thing, I want you to label it as such so that we know what we're talking about there. And that's the only, that's really minor. Otherwise, well done. All right.